Unmanned aerial vehicles are pretty amazing. They can do things that were impossible just a few decades ago and save lives in ways that could change the course of battle forever. The only problem is that these incredible machines have grown too big to fail. They've gone from being disposable aircraft that could handle critical side missions to full-size jets that cost more than manned aircraft. If they want to stay the crucial assets they are, they need to go back to their old ways while staying as capable as they are today. This is where the XQ-58A Valkyrie comes in. The XQ-58 Valkyrie is an experimental stealthy unmanned combat aerial vehicle designed and built by Kratos Defense and Security Solutions for the United States Air Force's low-cost, attritable strike demonstrator program. The goal of the program is to design and build unmanned combat aerial vehicles faster and more cost-effectively than before. The Valkyrie was built in just over 2 years after the contract was signed, and it's expected to cost less than $2 million per unit. That makes it the perfect fit for the job. While $2 million may not seem like much, it's a drop in the bucket compared to the $136 million drones, like the MQ-25, and the $180 million drones, like the RQ-4A BAMS-D. The XQ-58 is a game-changer on the battlefield thanks to its impressive capabilities. The XQ-58's low cost allows the US Air Force to build an entire swarm of them. Kratos officials have said that the company can produce between 250 and 500 XQ-58s a year, far more than any major military aircraft today. The XQ-58 must first prove itself to achieve this. There were 5 test flights planned for the unmanned aircraft in 2 phases to evaluate system functionality, aerodynamic performance, and launch and recovery systems. It had its first flight on March 5, 2019, and it's been one successful test after the other ever since. On July 23, 2020, Kratos got another contract from the Air Force to compete for the Skyborg program, along with General Atomics, Northrop Grumman, and Boeing. The Skyborg program was all about putting together low-cost, almost expendable wingmen to escort 5th and 6th generation manned fighters into battle. The XQ-58 is currently a top contender for this role. If it's chosen, it'll be the US Air Force's next-generation collaborative combat aircraft. The US Air Force's program for future air dominance, known as the Next Generation Air Dominance, NGAD, includes a section called Collaborative Combat Aircraft, CCAs. These unmanned aircraft will be the loyal wingmen, harnessing cutting-edge disruptive technologies such as autonomy, machine learning, and artificial intelligence to support manned fighters in executing their missions. The loyal wingmen are designed to perform a variety of tasks during missions. These include carrying weapons and flying ahead to provide intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance, as well as electronic warfare and even striking targets directly. Fielding such aircraft in their numbers could help achieve comprehensive battle space surveillance and agile combat employment from different altitudes at different angles, which could make mission planning more dynamic and flexible. The US Air Force can't afford to be without these benefits. They're planning to spend over $6 billion over the next 5 years on developing CCAs. In 2024, the Air Force is expected to launch a competition to decide which contractor will develop these aircraft. Kratos is expected to be a likely contractor for the job. The 2,500-pound aircraft can carry a payload almost half its weight, reach speeds up to 652 miles per hour, hit a service ceiling of 45,000 feet, and fly across a maximum range of 3,500 miles. Impressive numbers for an unmanned aerial vehicle of this class, and it backs it up too, with action. By March 2021, the XQ-58 had completed 6 successful flight tests, including one where they tested their weapons bay by releasing a 27-pound area-wide Altius 600 unmanned system. We are pleased to report that both the US Marine Corps and the US Navy have ordered 2 XQ-58s each for some in-house testing of their own to determine how well the aircraft fits into their respective programs. The Air Force continues with its tests too. We are hopeful that the US Air Force will be able to achieve its goal of having a CCA design actually in production by 2028. With the XQ-58 in service as the CCA, the service plans to acquire at least 1,000 units to escort 500 fighters into battle. The configuration for this is straightforward. Each manned fighter is escorted by a pair of collaborative combat aircraft to provide a single manned fighter with the ability of a small fleet. It is our understanding that the 500 manned fighters in question will include 200 5th generation F-35 Lightning IIs and 300 6th generation NGAD fighters, which we believe will be the air superiority fighter of the future. NGAD stands for Next Generation Air Dominance. It is precisely what it is designed to achieve. Air dominance of the next generation of aircraft. To achieve this, an entire suite of new technologies must be produced, including sensors, engines, battle management strategies, weapons, and a brand new next generation manned fighter. The NGAD fighter is the new air superiority fighter of the future for the US Air Force. It will be at the forefront of their plans in the sky. The fighter has the widest array of jaw-dropping capabilities. The NGAD fighter will build on the stealth technology of previous American aircraft, including fighters and bombers. Like the B-2 Spirit, the stealthiest aircraft in service today, the NGAD fighter will take an overall triangular shape, internally hold its payload, and have no vertical stabilizers. It is the first fighter ever to have such a revolutionary design. Up until the B-2 Spirit, vertical stabilizers were always needed to keep an aircraft airborne. The B-2 Spirit was the first to use active flow control, which uses onboard computers to adjust the flow around the aircraft to keep it airborne, just like birds fly. The United States has learned from decades of history that an aircraft will always have room to be better, no matter how advanced it is. This is especially true in the context of near-peer adversaries becoming more near-peer by the day. Therefore, the NGAD fighter will come with an open architecture that enables the fighter to take on new upgrades easily and quickly. This way, the fighter will be able to adapt to newer challenges of the battlefield that are introduced by the advancements of opposing militaries. In essence, the 6th generation NGAD fighter can be upgraded to become the 7th generation NGAD fighter, years after its initial fielding. The NGAD fighter will be equipped with the most sensitive sensors ever installed on a fighter. The Air Force will do away with radars mounted on the aircraft for electronically configured smart skins integrated into the aircraft's fuselage to achieve this. The information acquired by these sensors will be made available to other members of the fleet, whether 6th generation or not. This will keep the entire fleet of friendly aircraft abreast of relevant information in real time. The Air Force fleet instantly becomes a tightly interconnected force in the sky. And this is all thanks to the connectivity of its new fighter. The NGAD fighter will be kitted out with weapons that the Raptor, its predecessor in air superiority, uses and more. Like the Raptor, the new fighter will have missiles, bombs, and possibly a massive rotary cannon. Unlike the Raptor, however, the NGAD fighter could have laser-guided energy weapons that take out threats with high-intensity laser beams. These have loads of advantages over legacy weapons. 1. Laser weapons have unlimited magazines because they can keep firing as long as they're connected to a power source. 2. They can strike targets at 180,000 miles per second, which is the speed of light, the fastest thing in the universe. Targets would have to do the impossible to evade them. 3. Laser weapons are autonomous in operation, as they execute the majority of their work without human intervention. The Air Force has multiple laser weapons in the works, but the most promising of these remains the Self-Protect High-Energy Laser Demonstrator, or SHIELD for short. SHIELD is being developed by a team of Northrop Grumman, Boeing, and Lockheed Martin, three of the largest defense contractors in the world, and the three most likely contenders to build the fleet of 6th generation NGAD fighters. At least until Northrop Grumman dropped out of the running last year. Another advantage for the NGAD is the Raptor's ability to have a fleet of armed, loyal wingmen flying alongside to help make the mission a success. The XQ-59 is the focus of this video, and it aims to be these loyal wingmen. Its CV is looking good, and it just might be the Air Force's pick.